who invented it is a very shadowy and strange thing. Obviously, you know, the internet seems to have come from organisations like Rand. Social media has developed in such a way through blogging. I mean, I'm of an age where I remember when the internet didn't exist. I mean, what's strange is that, as I say, you've got a whole generation of people who don't understand that Facebook has not always been around, that YouTube has not always been around, that taking selfies and having a smartphone and having, you know, a video camera in your pocket, that's not normal. That's not the way that it is. What's really strange about, say, particularly something like Facebook, is the way that it's called social media. It forces you to be less social. The more participating you are in social media, the less real socialization you actually have. And that is pretty dangerous. There was a document. There's a document that's still used. It's called the Q-Bark document. It was taken directly from the MKUltra experiments, the mind control experiments. Basically, what they were doing is wiping people's memories. They were wiping people's memories because they had depression or something like that, and then basically putting new memories in. If this wasn't always successful, basically people were reduced to the level of a newborn infant. But from this therapeutic stuff, mysteriously, a torture manual called the Kubark document, which is still used by the American government and various entities, was taken out. Now, the principle technique that was described in this document is to isolate people and to overstimulate them. So this is why you would see people with, you'll put them in 24-hour isolation but keep a light on and perhaps put the noise, like static noise or white noise, in the background. We've seen this. They even do that in prison. Why do they do that? It's because it destroys your personality. It literally causes you to go insane. It's very, very old, tried and tested technique. Now, what is better at causing isolation and overstimulation than social media?
Hallo zusammen, hier ist der Jean-Jacques aus Bern, der hört Radio Cineola.